Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Chapter some basic principles and techniques in organic chemistry, and we are doing the topic difference between inductive effect and electromeric effect. Hello friends, in the previous lecture we have discussed about the electromeric effect and we have also discussed about the inductive effect. So now we are going to do a short difference between, and we'll analyze that what is basically the main difference between these two, that is the inductive effect and the electromeric effect. So let us talk about this one. So now we are getting to the concept where we could see that side by side that what is actually electromeric effect and what is inductive effect, and that is what we are going to differentiate between these two, and let us understand it. So talking about the inductive effect first, and these are the two differences that I am talking about. So talking about the inductive effect, so it means that is the polarization of a sigma bond due to electronegativity difference between the bonding atoms is basically known as inductive effect. And basically when it comes to sigma bond, basically we are talking about that is covalent bond. So in this case, inductive effect is only showcased by basically the one which is covalent bond. And we have did an example so in this case also that in this case there is basically the displacement of electron density towards the other atom, but it depends on the electronegativity or electronegativity of the atom that has been attached in this molecule. So the one which is more electronegative, it will try to approach the electron of or electron density of the other one toward itself, making this to have a basically partially negative charge as well as partially positive charge, making this to be more polar. And that is the reason this kind of inductive effect is what we could see in the molecules, just like that of CH3Cl or methyl chloride, in which we have got to know that methyl is the one which is showing plus I effect, or the molecule or the group of molecules that has the tendency to lose electrons and hence acquiring a partially positive charge, while that of the Cl, which is the one which has the tendency to grab electrons, and that is the reason that it has partially negative charge. And because of which we could see that because of the partial positive charge and partially negative charge, the polarity is what we could see over there, and that kind of effect is basically seen in those molecules, and that kind of effect is basically permanent. And talking about this one, that is in electromeric effect, the complete shift of pi bond of the carbon-carbon double bond or any double bond to one of the atoms joined by it in presence of a suitable reagent. So this kind of effect is only observed because of the complete shift of the pi bond electrons towards an atom which is forming a multiple bond with the another atom, and in this case this kind of effect is only shown in presence of a suitable reagent. So based on this also, that is electromeric effect, we have did an example. And in that case, suppose if I am talking about when carbonyl group is been approached with a suitable electrophilic region like that of AlCl3. So in this case, we have got to know that the carbonyl group, which is already a polar, which is having a polarity. So because of the AlCl3, it will acquire more polarity because AlCl3 is the one which is electrophile, and that is the reason that we could see the shifting of electrons during the during the displacement of the electrons, where we could see that one pi bond is been displaced to a particular atom, and that is the reason that it forms an intermediate, and then we find that the carbon which acquires a positive charge, while the other the group that has been approached approaching towards that carbon group that acquires a negative charge. So in that case also we could find the polarity, but this kind of effect is basically temporary, and it will depend on the suitable reagent that we are using. So these are the two differences that we could see, and the major difference that we could see is it takes place for a sigma bond, while this takes place for a the one which consists of pi bond. So now let us move on to the another one. So that is what I was discussing about, that is it is present in the sigma bond that we could see, that the inductive effect is the one that could be observed in the sigma bond, while that of the electromeric effect, it is possible with only the one which has pi bonds, that is the one which can form multiple bond, or the molecules that can form multiple bond like that of an alkene or that kind of a carbonyl. So they have a capacity to form multiple bond. So now talking about the next one is this is a permanent effect. While talking about the electromeric one, it is basically a temporary effect. So this is a permanent effect, that is because it deals with the electronegative atom that has been attached or that has been present in the molecule, and because of which we could see that polarity arises, and that's the reason that this kind of effect is basically permanent. And talking about this is temporary effect. The reason behind that is it already has a multiple bond, but it will depend on the approach of the electrophile, and that's the reason it is it could be a temporary effect, and that's the reason that the shifting of pi electron that takes place on a particular atom makes it to showcase that it would be a temporary effect. And talking about the next one, that is, it doesn't need any reagent. So this effect or this kind of effect is approach, or this kind of effect we could see in a particular molecule because of the presence of the electronegative difference, or we could say polarity. But talking about this one, that this kind of effect, it arises because of the reagent that has been involved in this case. And that's the reason that we could say that to exhibit this kind of effect, we need a particular electrophile reagent or some kind of suitable reagent that would differentiate either to induce the polarity, or we could say for a non-polar to a polar, that is nothing but the induction of a non-polar to polar molecule, while or else it could increase or enhance the polarity of a particular molecule which has polarity. So therefore this needs an electrophilic reagent so as to give this kind of effect. So therefore these are the two differences that we have got to know. So that's it. Thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have liked this video and you have understood this concept very clearly. And I hope you will share this video with friends. And yes, don't forget to subscribe to Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.